All right, I'd like to thank all of you for taking the time out of your busy schedules to be here today. Greatly appreciated. Most of you know we'll be here to discuss the OptumX firearm policy. Quick introduction for those of you that don't know me, my name is Joe Sirio. I'm the manufacturing group leader for the Prototype Sphere Plano product group. I've been with the company now for a little over 20 years. So, brief agenda, we'll be discussing the problem, the background, purpose, the solution, the schedule, staffing, and most importantly, the budget. So I'd like to start off with showing you a brief video clip called Run, Hide, Fight. This is an instructional video, so we won't be watching the whole thing, but this is just to give you an idea and put you into perspective of these people here.
It may feel like just another day at the office, but occasionally, life feels more like an action movie than reality. The authorities are working hard to protect you and to protect our public spaces. Sometimes bad people do bad things. Their motivations are different. The warning signs may vary, but the devastating effects are the same. And unfortunately, you need to be prepared for the worst.
To stop it right there. Again, if you put yourself in these people's perspective, do you have any idea what you would do here in this situation? Any idea at all? No? Of course not. Why would you? You've never been put in this situation. You've never been trained for it. So, here lies the problem. Our current firearm policy at OptumX restricts possession of any weapon on company premises. I believe at OptumX there is a false sense of security. People like to feel all warm and fuzzy. You know, we have these good security systems. We have the newly enacted personnel badges to get in and out of the building. Sounds great. Doesn't mean we're safe. So, purpose of this is to increase the safety of the workforce by amending the current firearm policy. Some advantages of amending the current firearm policy, obviously, security, right? We have people coming and going all the time, contractors, vendors, customers, unfamiliar faces. We have no idea who these people are. Even with the new entrance badges, people can still get in. It's very easy. Especially current employees who already have access to the building. God forbid they become disgruntled. They're already in here. And it's no secret that we do work for the defense industry. Many people, political agendas, and do not like that, do not agree with it. Just another reason to gain entrance. Could be more appealing to prospective candidates. A safe work environment is obviously more appealing than an unsafe work environment. Also, employee retention. Again, God forbid we have the situation of an active shooter. How many people do you think are going to feel safe sticking around here afterwards? Probably not too many, huh? I don't think so. So, some disadvantages. Any idea what disadvantages might be? said, some employees may feel uneasy. Well, it's natural to feel uneasy around things we don't understand. People that would feel uneasy most likely don't have proper training or experience handling or using a firearm. The key here is this is concealed carry only, which means they'll never be seen. Most people won't even know whose has them at any time, so it shouldn't be an issue. Any other reasons why? Good point, okay. Employees may decide to settle arguments by shooting each other. Well, this may sound ridiculous, but in reality, it is a possibility. But you gotta ask yourself, should anybody be working at OptiMax that we have to be concerned about shooting or acting violently against another person during an argument? And most importantly, we have the adult contract, which we hold in high regard here at OptiMax. And it works out pretty well for most situations. So, the solution, there are many trainings available all right here in the Rochester area. There's a company called Rochester Personal Defense that has several trainings, which I've listed here. So what I'd like to suggest is that any qualified employee, by qualified I mean a current pistol permit holder or would like to get their pistol permit, willing to volunteer would take a 47-hour armed security guard training. Right. This is the same training that armed guards would take, leaving banks or working at banks. Obviously, I would recommend further training beyond that, but that would be up to the individual's discretion. I believe the security guard training alone would be sufficient. Optional for the rest of the workforce, Rochester Personal Defense also offers a personal defense training for colleges, groups, and corporations. This training actually does entail some training for active shooting situations, like you just witnessed in the video before. So, schedule, timeline. Effective January 1st, 2016, OptiMax will begin registering all qualified volunteers for the 47-hour security guard training. Upon completion of this security guard training, all participants will be encouraged to continue with the further trainings available through Rochester Personal Defense or other companies, so they choose. Each volunteer will take the 8-hour annual firearm security training requalification course, And all remaining personnel will be encouraged to attend a 9-hour self-defense training for colleges, groups, and corporations, as I mentioned in the previous slide. I believe more experienced and prepared workforce has a better chance of surviving and pulling through a serious situation as an active shooter or a terrorist event. Staffing. I would like 2 qualified volunteers per shift to act as primary internal security guards. 6 total, 3 shifts per day. This should give us sufficient coverage for each shift. If one person happens to not be here, is sick for any reason, whatever the case may be. Their duties will include to engage and apprehend anyone threatening to cause bodily harm to any OptiMax employee. Alright, their first line of defense is to call the police once they've apprehended the suspect. In the event of an active shooter situation, first thing would be to sound the fire alarm. Next, we're going to locate and disarm the shooter. This is not the time to worry about or tend to injured victims. The fire alarm will bring people who are qualified to do that for you. Your first priority is to get the active shooter, disarm him, go from there. Most and foremost, uphold the adult contract. This is key adult contract states strictly on it, adults don't shoot each other. Sounds funny again, but this has to be upheld. So, budget. Optimax will budget for up to $10,000 annually. This includes $575 per person for the security guard training and 5% hazard compensation pay for primary internal security. $75 per person for 9-hour self-defense training for colleges, groups, and corporations. And this would include 8 hours of PTO to any employee who would volunteer to do this training as a little bit of an incentive to get people to do it and better prepare our workforce. So, in summary, we've discussed the problem, which is current firearm policy, discussed the purpose, to recommend amending the current firearm policy, discussed the solution, just to supply training to anybody who is willing. We've discussed the schedule, which would be effective January 1st. We've discussed staffing, 2 primary security positions per shift, 6 total. And we've discussed the budget, which is up to $10,000 annually. That concludes this presentation. Are there any questions by anybody? Well, thank you very much.